Need to stay, need to stay, need to stay, need to stay low. Big smoke, come on, we wanna stay low.
Hey, welcome back, kids. It's me, Captain Garcia with the Leon Valley Fire Department. I hope you remember me. Well, I'm here again in October. Why October? Because it's Fire Prevention Month. Why is it Fire Prevention Month? Come on, I know you remember. It's October. Let me give you a hint. There was a big fire, not in our city, but another city. Yes, the Great Chicago Fire. It happened a long, 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 long time ago, and we don't want it to repeat. This happened October 8th, 9th, and 10th. In what year? 1871. We weren't here. But we don't want that to happen again. So that is why we do fire prevention in October. The only difference is I'm here in a video because of the coronavirus. I'm still gonna get the message across, but I'm gonna do it through here. I'm gonna show you the house, stop, drop, and roll, stay low and go, get out and stay out. It's not gonna change, but it's just a different venue. All right, kids, I'm gonna give you a quick recap on the Chicago Fire, the Great Chicago Fire. Okay, remember it happened in October, right? It burnt October 8th, 9th, and 10th, right? And that was in 1871. A long, long time ago. Like I said, we don't want it to happen again. So that's why we do fire prevention. Back then, everything was made out of wood. I mean, I'm talking about everything. Houses, sidewalks, barns, you name it. It was made out of wood. So if it caught fire and if it got out of hand, it's hard for the firemen to catch up. Now, we didn't have fire trucks like we had back then. We didn't have fire trucks like we do now. Back then, the fire trucks were pulled by horses, and they had pumps that they had to do it by hand. Buckets you throw it on the fire. If it went away from us, we couldn't catch up to it. So we tried it. We tried our best. Chicago still burned down. We don't want this to happen again. Y'all remember what the story is that started the Great Chicago Fire? It's not true, but it's a myth. Y'all remember? Let me give you a hint. Yeah, it's a cow. The O'Leary farmers, remember them? It's said that their cow was eating its hay, minding its own business, and the tail decided to hit the lantern. The lantern fell. Of course, instead of electricity, it's fire. They caught the hay on fire, the cow took off, the barn caught fire, and it just kept going. The whole city of Chicago burned. That is a myth though, that didn't really happen. Actually, in 1997, the court said, it's not your fault, Miss O'Leary, but she was already passed. They finally forgave the cow and Miss O'Leary. Correct?
No, they wasn't. They didn't have a plan. They don't know where to go. They got up and ran right around the smoke. They were discombobulated. They didn't know where they were going. That is not the right way. They need to practice eating. They need a place where the parents know where they're at. A meeting place, right? They also need to stop running. You gotta get low and go. Get out and stay out. They didn't do it right. Let's see if we can try it again.
All right, guys, we need to practice our escape plan. We need two ways out, and we need somewhere to meet so our parents know where we're at. Y'all remember a little girl named Edith? I know y'all do. Edith, come on. Edith, exit drills in the home. E-D-I-T-H, Edith. Y'all need to practice that. But remember, when you practice Edith, you need two ways out. When the smoke alarm goes off and there's smoke, you need to get low and go. Once you get out of the house, you get out and stay out. You go back in for your PS4? 5? No. What about your dogs? No, they'll find their way out. Remember, two ways out. Get low, go, get out, and stay out.
Fire over here, guys.
Was that done correctly? I think it was. They had two ways out. They didn't panic. They got low and they went, right? They saw fire, turned around, they found another way out. Once they got out, where did they go? To their meeting spot. Now their parents know exactly where they're at. Remember, get low and go. Two ways out. Once you're out, stay out. They had a good Edith plan. Practice, practice, practice. Good job, kids. All right, kiddos, I hope you really paid attention to Timon and Pumbaa. They got a little bit of science in them. They spoke about a little triangle, right? About the fire pit conclusion. Okay, three elements in that triangle. Oxygen, heat, and fuel. You knock any of those elements out of that triangle, there is no more fire. Us as firemen, when we put water on a fire, we take out the heat. That's one element. That's why the fire goes out. If you have a candle and you put salt or sand on it, it goes out also, right? You just took out the oxygen. Like I say, you take out any of those elements, there is no fire. We're gonna pretend these buckets here is the fire tetrahedron. They're gonna try and be firemen and knock out the fire. Get it out, kids. That's one element. Hit it, girl. That's all right. Your partner here helped you out. Triangle's out. No more fire. Good job, guys. You know what this is? I really, really hope you do. And I really hope you have them at your house. It depends how big your house is and how many you will need. But I really would like for you to have one. If you do not have one, contact your fire department. We will help you and put one in for you for free. This is called a smoke detector. What does it do? Well, it detects smoke. Hello. This is what it sounds like. Pretty loud. This is supposed to be loud because it's got to wake you up in the middle of the night. It's not like your alarm when you say, Mom, give me 5 more minutes. You can't have 5 more minutes with that. That could cost your life. If you hear this, make sure you get low and you go. Once you get out, you stay out. Go to your meeting spot, right? Good. Okay, so they have batteries. These have to be changed twice a year. Best time to change these are daylight savings. Tell your parents, we gotta change our clocks, we gotta change the battery. Please make sure you do that. This saves life. Smoke detectors. Get one. If you don't, call us, we'll get you. All right, kids, fire prevention theme of the year, 2020. Serve up fire safety in the kitchen. That means be very, very careful when you're cooking in the kitchen. That means do not leave utensils, such as this, by the stove. It has to stay 3 feet away. When you put your food on the stove, stay there until it's done cooking. Do not leave, leave it unattended. Something can and will happen. So remember, everything stays out of the kitchen if you're not using it. You keep your food attended. Never leave it until it's cooked. Got it? Let's run through a little scenario real quick, see what happens.
Bear, come back, you're missing the game.
Hey, you left the stuff on the mitt. Hey, Sparky, come help me out, please. Come here. Thanks, Sparky. That's good, Sparky. Thanks. See what you just did?
Sorry.
Do not leave the food unattended, and do not leave your stuff less than 3 feet away. Go watch the game. Sparky, I appreciate you. Thank you so much. Okay, kids. That can happen in an instant. This is outside. If you were inside, that would have been a no-no. Keep it away. Like I mentioned before, you need to keep your stuff 3 feet away if you're not using it at the moment. There's a lot of people that like using the wooden spatulas. Leave it on there because they say the foam goes away. That is not true. Keep it 3 feet away if you're not cooking. I'm gonna show you one more scenario of what could happen, okay?
Eric, come
back. You're missing the game. Eric, not again. Look, he left the spatula on the pot again. He got to see the dang game. Sparky, one more time. Please help me put this up. Thank you, Eric. You're not gonna cook anymore. You're done cooking. Okay. Somebody else cook for this man, please.
All right, kiddos, let's do a quick recap of the videos we just watched. Utensils. Don't leave them on the kitchen table, on the kitchen stove. 3 feet away. That includes the mitts, tongs, anything you use. Always keep an eye on what you're cooking. Do not leave it unattended. Help your parents out. Don't forget, this month, fire prevention team is serve up fire safety in the kitchen. That also means outside. Thank you for watching, and be careful while trick-or-treating. Let your parents check your candy. Do not cross the street by yourself, and always carry a flashlight. Happy fire prevention.